What's going on, everyone? Tech Me Out here, and in front of me, I have my new Samsung Galaxy Note 10 Plus. I finally have it set up the way that I want after many hours, and I do mean many, hours of dedication in getting it this way. I finally am at a point to share it with you all. So, let's talk. Most, if not everything, in which I'm mentioning in the video is gonna be linked down below in the description box, so feel free to check that out. But yeah, I'm kinda proud of this setup. So here we go. Starting with my lock screen. What I chose to go with is this really cool Hulk wallpaper. I like this particular one. It was something about the way that the Hulk hid the camera cutout. And on top of that, just, I don't know, the colors, the look, just the flow of everything all together. I was really digging, so I made it my lock screen. Now, if you take a look down here at the bottom, you'll probably notice that looks a little bit different. And that was achieved with something known as Good Lock. So that's an application that I'm probably gonna make mention of quite a bit in this video. It's unfortunately not in the Play Store, but I'm gonna still give you a link so you can download it and start utilizing some of these features as well, because you can customize so much. Starting with something like this, so you can hide your clock. In my case, I wanted mine to remain visible. And then I have my little icons there representing my notifications. So a very nice clean look here. So at this time, I'm gonna just go ahead and unlock things. I don't have a screen protector on my phone, and I'm currently rocking a clear case from Taraz. But I will be investing in a screen protector. So yeah, no worries there. But a little FYI, I will say this wallpaper was originally like designed for the Samsung Galaxy S10, you know, because it has that little area there where it would normally have the camera cutout. But I still thought it looked great on my Note 10 Plus, so I went with it anyway. Okay, so let's talk a little bit about what we have going on here. Starting at the top, you'll notice my status bar is hidden. That was done with Nova Launcher, and I actually have the pro version, and I customized a few other things, such as the option for my widgets to overlap or overlay on top of each other. I also got rid of my icon labels, and I installed a custom icon pack known as Nexa. I really like it because I think it just flowed very well with the wallpaper. And on top of that, when I swipe up to my app drawer here, pretty much all the icons flow very well, because I know sometimes with some of these custom icon packs, you know, certain apps just aren't themed and it just looks incomplete. It doesn't look, I don't know, clean. It doesn't look nice when you come up in here because you see the inconsistency with the look of the applications, and that just drives me nuts. It like sometimes makes me actually not use a certain icon pack despite how much I like the icons. But in this case, I didn't have that problem because everything flows to the point that, you know, even those that aren't themed just look good amongst the others that are themed. And then not only do you have icons that you can choose from, you also have wallpapers. So yeah, you're gonna get, I can't even say money. I don't know if I paid for that or not, but either way, you're gonna enjoy it if you download it. And then moving over here to the left side, this widget is known as off time. And I really like this because it allows me to stay focused when I'm working and I'm getting distracted by my phone, by, you know, going on Instagram and YouTube and whatever other apps that I'm on that I don't need to be on. This will help make sure that I don't get up there. So pretty much all I have to do to get it going is just tap on it and then it starts. And I currently have mine set to keep me focused for 45 minutes on my task. So it's only gonna allow me access to a very select few apps, which you can choose. And you can name different profiles and everything like that. Maybe you wanna set up a profile for when someone else, you know, is using your phone momentarily, like guest account or guest profile. You can do that so that only certain apps can be used. So those are just a few little scenarios to get, you know, your wheels turning on how that could be useful for you. Now moving on to the apps here. So of course I have Amazon, if you don't know. And just about any what's on my Android or iPhone video, Amazon is gonna be there. Then I have Google Play Store. Next to that, I have Feedly so I can get all my news. And then next to that, I have Google Home. And then this icon here is actually a shortcut that I made from Google Home so that when I tap on it, it'll instantly start listening and identify the song that's playing. So I liked that on the Google Pixel, so it kind of brought it over to the Galaxy Note here. Now the way you go about making that shortcut is to find your Google app, long press on it, and then choose these little four squares, and then select sound search and drag it onto your home screen, and you'll have the same shortcut that I do. Now moving on to the next row, we have my notebook app. This is pretty much where I go and I jot down like all my different notes. I have different notebooks for different, I guess, subjects and such. This is my go-to app for like jotting down my thoughts because I like the fact that it actually can sync over to my iPhone and my MacBook, so everything is then working smoothly together. And then next to that, I actually made a shortcut so that I could immediately go in and start writing a note. And the way I went about doing that is that I long pressed on the notebook application and then I dragged the write option up here. And that's what it looked like originally, but I didn't like the icon, so I long pressed on that, hit edit, and then I chose the icon here, went down to my icon pack, and then found something that I felt would represent to me that I could create a new note. Next to that, I have my Apple Music application, and then next to that, I have a search option, which is actually a shortcut that I made from the music app. So, same process that I did for the notebook, long press on the music app, take search, drag it onto your screen. So then I could just tap this and instantly search for a song without having to go in the app and navigate to the search option. Next to that, I have my weather app, Instagram. If you don't follow me on Instagram, what are you doing? I'm joking, nah. If you don't follow me on Instagram and you wanna get some behind the scenes things or just communicate with me a little bit more, you can check me out up there under Tech Me Out, TECHME0UT. Then for Twitter, I use Talon. Next to that, I have Lightroom, my gallery, so I can quickly look at my photos. I use Google Sheets, or I'm getting more into using Google Sheets. My settings, calendar, Google Maps, Studio, and YouTube. Yeah, I think outside of that, yeah, all of these are default apps down here as well, so cannot forget this little navigation down here. So the way I themed my navigation bar and my lock screen was with this app right here. And you can theme so much more, like your notification center, even your toggles, you can change the colors of that as well, which I have done. So you're just gonna go in here and choose the one that you want. So example, down here to get my navigation bar to look like that, I downloaded Navstar by just tapping on it. And then after it installed, I went in here and I chose the theme that I wanted. So you can have your typical 3 points of navigation, you know, your multitask switcher, home and back, or recents. But what I did is I added another icon down there so that I can easily take a screenshot at any time. Because with the new Note 10 and the Note 10 Plus, you know, with having your volume button on the same side as your power button, sometimes it can be a little tricky in actually taking a screenshot. But now I can do that with ease because I do take a lot of screenshots. So instead of having to pull up my S Pen or hit those buttons, boom, I'm good to go. So moving on to my second page, I only have 2 pages set up. I like to keep things kind of clean and minimal as much as possible. But on this page here, I have my widgets. So at the top here, I have my calendar. This is with monthly calendar widget. It's just a really nice free calendar widget application. It's super clean. I love the fact that when I have my calendars turned on, I can see them by the color they're associated with, meaning like my work calendar is one color, personal calendar is another. I can just look right here and get what I consider like a desktop experience from my phone by seeing the events on the day and the colors of the calendars. So yeah, it definitely keeps me on track. And then beneath my calendar, I have my weather widget to give me a glimpse of what the weather is going to be for the week. And this is known as today weather. And then moving down here to the bottom, this widget is known as done. This is going to allow me to pretty much have like a to-do list so that I can easily come in and add things that I want to complete for the day or keep track of the things that I need to do. So the way I would go about adding something is to hit this plus symbol. I can type basically a task for today, tomorrow, or other in here. So I'm gonna say, what do I wanna do? I need to grocery shop for sure. So I'm gonna say grocery shopping. And then I'm gonna hit this little save icon right here. And when I go out to the home screen, I'll see all the things that I need to complete for today, and then I can add, you know, for tomorrow and such like that. But yeah, this is kind of the layout that I like. I like to keep apps on one page, widgets on another. And in regards to the other apps that I have on my phone, you're just gonna have to come back for that. I'll do like a little swipe and you can pause and take a look. But yeah, I just really wanted to give you an idea of my current setup. I'm gonna be doing a top 5 apps video very soon, so stay tuned for that. So yeah, that's pretty much what I have on my Note 10 Plus. Definitely stay tuned for some more content. If you enjoy this video, feel free to give it a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button if you want to, in fact, get some more content from me. And as always, thanks for taking the time out to let me tech you out.